Welcome back to my channel. Today I wanted to show you something I used to do when I was a few years younger that I thought would have been a great way to make extra cash. As you can see, I collect cans to scrap them for money. And here's all the cans I've collected over the past 2 years or so. And I wanted to show you that I crush them, because it'll take up a lot less space if you crush them compared to if you just leave them uncrushed. And to show you perspective, so here's one uncrushed can on the left, and on the right is six crushed cans. So about six crushed cans is equivalent to one uncrushed can in terms of how much space it would take up. So that would definitely add up if you leave the cans uncrushed, and it would take up a lot more space. So if you want to leave the cans uncrushed, then you should think about if you have the space to store uncrushed cans. Like, if you have some sort of large 18-wheeler to store them in, or a huge, like, garage that has a lot of space for dozens of bags. But if you're like me and you don't have too much space, then I would definitely recommend crushing your cans to save up space. These are, like, dozens of pounds of cans. I lifted the bags. It might be, like, I'm not sure. I guess we'll find out when we weigh them how much each bag weighs worth of crushed cans. Here's some recent cans that I decided not to crush just because I didn't see the point in crushing them the same day that I'm gonna scrap them. And I used to do it more like actually searching for cans. But now I just kind of casually collect cans as my family drinks them. Like before, I would go to the apartment complexes if there was like a pool party. And then I would look in the garbage cans for different aluminum cans to scrap. But recently, I've just been kind of casually collecting the cans. So, and these two were all from like the first 6 months. This one was after, these cans were from after this bag of cans, and you know, these bags of cans were from after when I was just casually collecting them. So I haven't been collecting them nonstop, which I think would be important to let you know. So if you collect them nonstop for as long as I've been collecting them, then you might make more money than what I would make. But anyways, I'm gonna get these cans packed up and I'm gonna see how much money I'll make off of them. Going up the conveyor belt.
61 pounds. Wow.
Yeah, go.
Thank you, sir.
All right, yeah, have a good weekend.
You too. Nice. $24.
Okay. How you doing? You filming?
Yeah. Okay. Filming the experience.
The experience. How was your first time here with us?
Yeah.
Yeah, how was your experience with us?
It was cool.
Okay. Are you gonna be coming back soon to recycle again?
Well, the cans that I collected, I accumulated over a few years, so
okay. But that's awesome though, you got some money.
Yeah.
All right, buddy. You have $24. And those 10, 20, 1, 2, 3, and 4. And just so you know, you gotta have 60 pounds on your aluminum cans, and it was 40 cents a pound. Okay. All right, here you go, $24.
Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome. Have a good one.
You too. Bye. It looks like someone was trying to scrap some sort of brass dragon and a horse. It's pretty cool. I just made it back from the recycling center, and as you can see, I got the money. Got $24 in cash, no tax. And you might be wondering, is it worth it? Would you do it again? And I'd say probably not. You know, it was just a fun thing to do when I was younger, before I was able to get a real job. Now you're much better off getting a real job rather than collecting cans or something like that. If you're underaged where you are too young to get a real job, then it'd be a fun thing to do. You won't make too much money, so don't have your expectations too high. But it was still a very cool process to see all of my cans in one large bag, and the people who worked there were very nice. And it was a pretty cool process. But anyways, I hope you enjoyed the video and got a good idea of the process of scrapping cans. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.